Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to create this simple loading bar which is also interactive. Okay, we are going to start by creating new composition. It can be 4K for 5 seconds, background color doesn't matter. Let's leave it comp 1. And now we are going to create background, so we're going to double click on the solid. It's going to create a solid that is the size of our composition. I'm going to change it to white and lock it. Now I'm going to create my loading bar. I'm going to create this shape, add it to stroke and no fill. And with my motion tools, I'm going to put my anchor point on the left side. Now to create my bar, I'm going to duplicate my border layer, just clicking Ctrl D, Command D on Mac, and put it below. Change the name to a bar, put non-stroke with fill. This is green. Now to make it look a little better, I'm going to create a little white space between the bar and the border. So I'm going to open my scale for the bar, uncheck constraint proportions, and zoom in a little and just see how it looks. Okay, so now I'm going to put it here, resize it a little here. So now we have our bar. So I'm going to keyframe the scale here from 0% and like here for our 100, but in this case it was 89.6 because 100, as you can see, will go a little further because I a little resized this. So now I'm going to create my text layer right below our bar, open the text and find source text. After that I'm going to add a slider control effect on our text layer. Slider control effect is an effect which can show you the value from negative numbers to positive numbers with zero in the middle. You can copy that value to your source text. So what I'm saying, you can put exact value in your text which can change in the time. So I'm going to show you. When you have your source text opened, just pick with the source text value and put it on the slider. So this is showing us only zero because this value doesn't change at all in time. So we are going to get back to our first keyframe on the bar and keyframe our slider and move to the second keyframe and put it 100 here. So as you can see, it rises, but there's so many decimal numbers, we're going to delete them by expanding our source text and finding our expression. Expressions are parts of the code which After Effects use to communicate between effects. And probably when you want to make an effect more complicated, you use expression. But we are not going to get into this deeper in this lesson. So we are going to just a little modify this line, just putting Math.round, open the bracket, and just close the bracket at the end. So we are gonna just mathematically round this number. And see, now it's going to only show us 90, 40, 70, but we are missing a percent. So we are gonna just put a plus with percent. You can see it's 0%, 50% in the middle, and 100% at the end. Now what you can do with this? You have 4 keyframes on your timeline. When you move the keyframes, the values doesn't gonna match. So you need to keep it in mind that the position of the keyframes must be exact, but also the easing on the keyframes must also be the same, because when I, for example, ease this below keyframes, you can see the value doesn't match because green bar is almost at 100 and showing 90%. Because we're gonna get into more deeply. This is our bar scale and this is our value. Bar scale is here and value is here. And they are very different. In this case, this value is going to be the same in this point and in this point. But we want to be the same the whole time. So we need to ease them together. And now we are gonna see what happens in our graph editor. As you can see, the lines align over each other. You can take, for example, last keyframe and push it a little here. So the loading bar is going to be very fast at the beginning and it's gonna a little slow down at the end. Also, the numbers are going to do the same. So let's see what happens now. And it's gonna work when you just push them farther or push them slower. So maybe we can extend it in the time. And make it a little faster. You can do whatever you want with this. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed it. You can use it whenever you show any rising or decreasing numbers or statistics. Remember to subscribe and see you in the next video. Bye.